What's up, everybody? Today I'm gonna be playing through the tower. Thanks for clearing everything up there, Bill. That was nice. So yeah, I'm gonna wait. First I should make sure. Okay, so I'm about to go up here and go into this tower and play through this dungeon and see how it feels. For the first time, actually. I need to check and make sure I have good items for all this. Or what I would have in the game. So I kind of, this is like a test, debug, save game. I want to make sure that everything's all set. So it kind of would be like I had just played through the game and I'm all the way to the last dungeon. You have all the items you would have by default, the minimum items you would have around. Not quite the minimum, but like, you know, of the average items you'd probably have at this point. So let's see, I've got Fire Blink. Alright, there's tons of blinks I could have. Fire blinks, alright. Poison top hat. Lightning sword. I got boots, gloves, fiber chip. I still could craft fear or ice. 8 demon's teeth? That's, yeah, that means I completed 8 dungeons. It means that I missed one. I got 1 flask, it's full. I got 3 kilobombs. Okay, cool. I think I want bombs, regular bombs. What's up, Teek? How's it going, Teek? What you working on today? Okay, I'm gonna save game. Oh, my music's off. Oh, the music's off. Okay. So this save is all ready to go to play through the tower. I'm going to start playing now. Still on it, finishing it up. Right on. Okay, I was in the dark a little bit there. Nice, designing a few new levels, right on. And polish. Polish, polish, takes so long. I do want to do some new art for that. And Vel's kind of messed up. All these things are little things on my mind I know I'm going to get done. But I don't think I'm going to have time to finish today. Whoa, shit, watch out for the bobs! I really want the rocks as well. Oh, shit. I forgot what button does what. Online high score. Sounds good. Boss fight. Oh man, I'm almost out of health already. These guys are really difficult. This tiny room as well. Best job. Oh man. I Yeah! Oh! Dang, that was hard! It only gave me 3 health, too, on the way. Damn! Okay, so what if I'm an idiot and I'm, or what if I'm like, okay, I want to go get more health before I go up the tower. Well, I could have just teleported. Dumb idea. All right, teleport it is. That tiny room though, that made it really hard. Yeah. Or what if I want to go get more flask? Yeah, that's a good point, right? Cause I do. I would gladly pay for another. Oh shit! This is totally what I feared. So if you leave the tower, you still have to beat him. That sucks. Damn. Oh wait, but the what? Anyways, I'm just gonna note that for now. Okay, so where am I gonna make notes? Where's my phone? Crazy guy, what's up? Use Notepad. I don't want to take away from the computer playing the game, though. I would put these on my Trello normally, but this is just something I'm going to do just today. So, okay, leaving the tower. Caused first boss to reappear with only one of them, but you could still use the elevator, which is so weird. Elevator art would be awesome. Oh, black to black. On entrance. All right, all 3 notes have now been written down and I can proceed with peace of mind. What about an option to use an active item straight from the inventory that you don't have to rebind keys for rare used items? Oh, that's a really great idea. That's a great idea. Teak, I'm writing that down too. That's awesome. So use an item straight from the inventory. That's cool. Okay, what I wanted to see is if I could teleport back to a courage refill, or actually back to the crash site. Because right around here, I think there's a store where I can refill my courage. It's either going to be the one to the right or the left, maybe. Because I'm like dead. I either need more health or... Whoa, watch out for that guy. Yeah, exactly. The teleporter is definitely one of those rare... Yes, this is the one. Teleporter's a rare use one. What's up, Arcane? How's it going? Alright, I got spirits now. And... I can't use my teleporter here. Whoa! Oh, dude, the delay on the blink is so... so low right now. Something happened there. Either that or it's using the wait. Okay, I want to warp back to the place. Oh no, it can't warp back there. Why not? There we go. Oh, damn it! Oh, I lost it. I lost that point. Okay, that's a bug too. So I lost my teleport last location by canceling at 600. And it didn't allow my location there. All right, teleport bugs. What's up? Pete and Wally, yo, how's it going? So I guess I'm just gonna cheat. Wait, no, I can warp to a teleport or one of those that's close. Yeah, so this one. What's up, Pedro? You started work. I thought so, man. How you doing, man? How's the job? Oh my god, that takes forever when you have lots of health. That's already on my list, though. God dang, go get yourself a coffee while this is going on. You know, right? Order a pizza, it could arrive before you finish uploading your health. Save? No, I don't want to save. So, does this mean that when I go back into the tower, I have to fight that boss again? Or will it just allow me up to the next floor? This is the question. This way. Dude, I totally thought there would be a secret there. Oh, found one. Oh, glitchy Z ordering bug. Taking training sessions? Oh yeah, you already know it. You got a client, right on. Wow, sweet. Pedro, awesome. Yeah, totally. With the timing, totally too, yeah. So I go straight. Oh, found another one. Damn it, I got plenty of gems. I want gems, diamonds. Okay, I'm back to the tower. Already lost 3 health. Let's do this. I hope I don't have to fight that boss again. This is totally tricky. You can totally spam the blink button right now. Yeah! I ran past him! Okay, so there's some bug where if you fight a boss and then you come back in the tower, you can just run around him. But they should still be dead, so I'll fix that. Ooh, thank you. This is a nice room. Once again, that was much more difficult with two of those bosses in a tiny room. I lost almost all my health, but that was successful. Nice! Oh, that was cool. I mean, with the refinements too, this is gonna be a cool dungeon. With like, once I work on, you know, all the art, once the game's all done and stuff, dang. That's gonna be a fun room. No, the tower is not just two of every boss. This is just a placeholder bosses. So I actually have specific bosses in mind I'm going to design just here for the tower. So this is just kind of, I ran out of time. I spent 2 weeks just working on the final boss. So, and I didn't even finish the final boss's second phase, second mode where he turns into something else. But anyways... this is just going to have to count for now. I'm going to put this up on Steam tonight, probably. And I got to get this out. I got to start working on some new stuff. And I'll save finishing the tower for when I come back and refine it. I'll spend another week or 10 days or 14 days, something like that. Just refining this whole dungeon and these bosses and stuff and creating the new bosses along the way. So in answer to your question, those are just placeholder bosses. Awesome, Pedro. What's up, Q-Lev? Alright, I did... Did I not use... Whoops. I do not want to teleport here. Okay, I still have my flask if I need it. But I think it would probably be better for this boss battle if I had Killabombs. As L there. Oh, two fire bosses. Oh, you can totally spam these guys if you're just invincible. So close to dying. Gotta use my flask. Oh, I got one of them. Sweet. You're dead. Nice. Alright. That wasn't that bad. If I can get to the top of this tower, I think I can teleport back even. And I even, because I just used a flask there. I don't need the scanner drones. I don't even want those scanner drones. How big is HSBC Bank in the USA? I have no idea. I would really like to see more stuff to more interesting stuff along the way in the tower. So this room and this room need to be, I need some special patterns that are going to work here to make it really interesting and unique. Maybe I could do a couple of those today, actually. Those are not very long. It'd take me like a half an hour to an hour. Yeah, some new patterns would be really quick and easy way to make this more fun. Ambiences still playing. It's like playing every ambience from this whole dungeon over and over. Boss again? Is it two lightning bosses? That's gonna be tough. Oh, you know what? I don't even have the shield. I totally should have the shield right now. Oh. That is kind of messing with this whole run here. Getting hit by stuff that I normally wouldn't. Not if I'm blinking. Oh, I think that works. Just gonna sit over there. Oh, I got four bombs left. Supposed to give you at least one health. Possible that I have to travel to the USA because of the project? Oh, beers! Right on, Pedro! Beers! What's up, Spymort? Holy crap. I think I'm dead. Well, if I can make it past him, though... Oh, damn it! Playing all the ambiences too. Didn't work. Didn't make it. So let's say I definitely should have the shield. That would really help. That's a really hard boss fight. You don't get any more bombs either. It should definitely throw you out of a couple bombs each time you fight one of those guys. So you should have at least the first shield at this point of the game. All right, so since I fought pretty much all those bosses, that last guy is really hard to fight twice in this in a game. I'm gonna go straight to the top of the tower. And I think I can teleport from there. Because this was, if I had beat that last boss, I'm pretty sure this is. This is the room I was just in fighting that guy. Yeah, alright. So let's say I beat him, which is totally possible. All right, and I use this. Save my game. See, I quit. Should start me there. But I should check and see if in release mode. I should double check release mode can start there. Lots of notes, lots of little notes to get done today before I put this version out. Stouts, I like cider myself. Hard cider is good stuff. I just like alcohol that's made from apples. Da 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 da. Vodka? You like vodka? I like gin. I like scotch, actually, is my favorite. Scotch is my favorite alcohol. Russian vodka is too strong for you, yeah? We had some 100 proof stuff in college, man. Oh, that was really strong. Dang. Why did we drink that? Why? Man, this build takes forever when you're streaming. All right, let's do this. Tell me it starts in the same place. But yeah. Yeah. Standing does hurt my feet a little bit after a while. Unless you kind of, I have to move around. You know, I have to move around. If I walk a little bit or I go over there or whatever, I stand, like move my legs and stuff. Like, that helps a lot. Okay, so if I save in release mode, I don't know if that's what it needed or what. No, okay, it doesn't save. Okay, bug noted. These are little things you gotta note and fix before you release your product. You've always wanted to try a standing desk, yeah? I find them to be, this is not really a standing desk. I work at, this is just in my closet, and I'm basically have my keyboard down here on some speakers, and then my laptop's up at the top. So, but yeah, standing desks, I've never actually used one, actually, but I love my little standing setup. It's so awesome. Love it. So I go back to the crash site. It saves my game. Huh. Okay. I can warp back to my last location. But let's say I cancel, so it should like forget my last location, right? According to the current bug. No, it didn't. There, now I forgot my last location. Yeah, see, it still doesn't have that refill, that courage refill on top of the tower, so you can't warp back to the top of the tower anymore. Which kind of sucks. I would like you to be able to, if you're gonna have a refill point up there, might as well be able to warp there. Let's make that really quick. Make that happen. The refill points. It is Cape Flux teleport. Sheath, teleport out. I guess it's teleport out. Ah, there's the interface. Okay, so it does an interface here. Oh, right. So it's interfaces teleport. We got home, ship, refills, get teleport destinations. There it is. I've been trying to find you, you little piece of code. Now I've got you. Well, that was easy. If it worked, let's see. No. Didn't work, probably because there's no cave flag refill on top of the world, which means I need to put that instead of setting pattern refill. Or just add refill. Ba 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 ba. There we go. It's got it listed as 00-9 though. So let's fix that. So if DZ, if so there, if it's the last level, for warping to the last level, it'll always just be D.Z is 10. Or I guess 9 would probably be a good one too for that. Either one, 9 or 10. Sweet. Okay, that works. If you make it to the top of the tower, you activate this courage refill. You can always warp back there. Okay, so I'm gonna do this now. I'm gonna play it, fight the final boss, see if this is even possible. I have no idea. I haven't played him yet with all of his abilities and everything. We have 30 bombs, 10 cactuses. Let's get kilobombs. I have a shield this time, which is so great. Thanks, Echo. I was just saving my item configuration there, in case I die, which I probably will. Anticipate when he's gonna hurt, trying to hurt me. Yeah, cacti, cactuses, whatever. You know what I meant. Okay, this is try number two. This might be a good place to hang out. That's not easy. Not easy at all. How much damage is he doing? Dang. Okay, if you ever hit him, you lose an entire... entire tooth. When he hits you with his sword, he's doing a whole damage and a tooth and a half, which is a good one to have at high damage because it's something you can kind of anticipate. You see him start the attack. And then he also hits you with his landing, which is super, does a ton of damage. And that's also something you've really got to watch out for. It's not landing, smash. What? What's it called? The super explosion. Oh, squash. Why did I call it squash? See, that does 6 damage. That's a ton. And then he's also got the super explosion, which is a wave of damage that does a whole 1. Wow. Okay, let's try and tweak things a little bit here. I'm gonna try the wave of damage being a little bit less. And I'm gonna try. Collision damage when you hit him as well. You step on, he steps on you essentially. Set that to a half. Which means your shield could possibly block it unless you've used your shield recently. Huh. Ha. Let's try it like that. If he's too easy, of course I could change this, but I don't think he's gonna be I still think he's gonna be hard. I guess you, if you're a smart player, you can jump over this the shockwave. Yeah, see if I had dodged that, that would have kept a lot of health there. Yeah, you gotta dodge that attack. Alright. Oh my god, I got hit by the squash! That is really damaging. Wow. It would be really helpful to have a little bit of shadow as he's falling from the sky like that. Which is the same as the acid boss. Guy's name is Murmuroth, not Marmoroth. I renamed him. All right. Where does he do that? Shadow Acid Boss. There it is. Okay, so I need a Shadow Acid Boss. What's up, Jonah? What's up, man? I'm playing the tower, the final boss and everything. I just played through the tower. Now I'm playing the final boss. Stream hype. What's up? How you doing, man? So I'm gonna copy Shadow Acid Boss to Shadow Metatron. And then Metatron, when he starts to land, just maybe here. Now let's do it right here. So we're gonna spawn Shadow Metatron. Playthrough hype. Yeah, I know I'm only playing through the dungeon, the last dungeon here, but I am gonna do an actual playthrough next week when I have this all finished and uploaded on Steam. Wait, I don't know if this is gonna work. Did you guys see a shadow there? I didn't see a shadow. Oh, I guess there was a shadow, but it's so faint. Let's make that shadow more shadowy. So, Shadow Metatron. Oval gradient black opacity starts at zero, fades into. Ooh, here we go. Let's make that fade in a lot darker. And here, when it fades out a lot darker. So it starts at timer 2.618. No, that's gonna need to be faster than that. He starts falling. I think he. Let's take off at least a second there. Oh, this is animate fade. Ah, there we go. Okay, so we need that to be fade. All right, there's the fade in, fade out. All right, let's see if that looks better. I just want some little hint that he's about to drop on a certain spot. It can be subtle. It doesn't have to be like super obvious, but just something. So if you're a good player, you can sense that he's about to drop on a certain spot and you're going to get the hell out of there, because that is a really damaging attack. Okay, that didn't fade in quick enough. And it faded a little too opaque, actually. Let's put that more like 0.8. And scale it a little smaller. And fade in way faster. Half a second, maybe. All right, these couple little tweaks to the boss here is going to make him a lot more fun, because right now he's like just basically impossible unless you're freaking awesome. Did anyone see a shadow there? Alright, if this doesn't work, I'm just gonna play him anyways. Slow-mo, oh, good idea. There's a little bit too much delay there. Yeah, it's not even there! It's just not there yet. No, like it never. I don't think I ever saw it. Oh, I scaled it though that time. Might have been the scale. Let's take that off. I saw it that time. It was I think it should fade in even faster. Oh, right, in slow-mo. Was it too faint? Let's go 9.9. Yeah, because he falls so fast, like he comes at one frame almost, like where he's... Especially for you guys, because you're seeing the stream at only like 15 frames a second. There it is. Okay, oh, that time. You could totally see it fade in. Definitely needs to fade in a little longer. Oh, this is so nice, just being able to see it now. Yeah, I saw it too. I saw it too, it was obvious, finally. Oh, see? Yeah! That was just about right. A little too low, though. So... Maybe more like 15 here. Yes, it's so great to work on things you can actually see. There we go. Okay, so it needs to only be like negative 5 there, and it could fade in a little slower actually, like 0.7 there. Okay, that looked better with the timing, but it was like still too low, so I'm gonna push it upward this time. It's almost right, and then I can play him. Then I shall continue the playthrough. Still too low. Fuck it. Let's go 15 more pixels and just play him. I don't care. I don't want to keep tweaking this forever. Oh, I'm tweaking the wrong one. No wonder. I was like, just a few more pixels. It wasn't doing anything. So that used to be negative 30. Let's try 0. All right, negative 10 it is. No more tweaking. Let's fight him. Oh, the damn, wait. Nah, yeah, let's keep it. Keep it. Yeah, I blinked at just the right time there to not get hit by him. Whoa! Okay. I do think his damage for hitting him should be at least 0.75, if not 0.1. And it's the same thing with his the super explosion. It should do a little more damage. So that's a nice balance between what it was before, where it was kind of too hard at 1, and at 05, it was kind of still, it was a little easy. Whoops. Got hit there. so quickly. I think I must have got hit. That was a good dodge. In phase two. Alright, I finally made it to phase two. Yes. You like the look? I was waiting for a good point to use that effect. I never really used it. I never really used the dash for the skill because the blink is kind of a dash. You. Oh, got him. He's doing flybys now. Damn you. He's running away right when I drop a bomb. Must know. Oh, damn. No. I'm almost dead. This is not looking good. If only I had another flask. He is lower than half health right now. It's so close. See there, it didn't give me any health from using the cactus. Damn it. Boogie, what's up? What's up, Loki Kappa? Is it shader magic? No, it's not even shader magic. It's just sprites. Okay, so I gotta reflect on my thoughts there from fighting him there. What do I need? What do I need to beat this guy? First of all, the cactuses should be doing what they're supposed to be doing. The cactuses are supposed to give you a full health every time you use them, no matter what. Oh, if factor. That's going to help a lot. Need more cowbell? Hey, let's try the ice top hat, all right? Let's see if that does make that much of a difference, huh? All right, ice top hat it is. I think this guy's immune to ice, though. I don't know. We'll see. All right, try it again. I think that's going to work to make the cactuses actually do what they're supposed to. The key is not getting squashed by him. If you get squashed, you're fucked. That's like six teeth of damage in one blow. An immune to ice equals broken. Yeah, you can still hurt him, but you know what? Let's make him not immune to ice. Let's see if that is cool or not. try it really quick. If it feels, because I wanted him to be, this is the final boss, I wanted him to be like really immune to like just, you know. That is kind of cool. Okay, screw it. Let's do that with everything. Right? This is the final boss. You should be able to use your most powerful stuff against his most powerful stuff. Right? He's immune to everything with your bare hands. Boogie's definitely going to vote on the other side. Boogie's going to be like, he should be invincible to all that. But let's try it. I'm just going to try fighting him this way. Now, not only will the ice top hat do something against him, the fire blanket will as well. Looks weird though with that, the flame getting him black for that long. That's in apply elements, I think. Ice freezes fire, creates burnt animation. Burnt for an entity. If it's a foe, I want this to only last a certain time. So, consplot duration equals any get. Makes it hard because you're all like, oh, I just use my most powerful weapons, and you waste your time doing zero damage. It's true. It's true. You're doing less damage than you're just doing normal damage. Which puts more importance on having the vibra chip and the gloves, which you just makes your sword powerful, you know? Yeah, is this even doing anything? Would you keep trying? I could have beat him. I could have beat him if I had tried like a couple more times, I'm sure. Alright, anyways. Collision component. Dot flags. Alright, if we have... No, this is category. Oh no, original category. If you have original category, foe, or friend, then the duration is, wait, what was it before? 5? This should be only like 1 second max. Maybe less. Alright. And then if you could get Jib, he's weak against Jib. Jib's shield does like five teeth worth of damage on him. One hit. If Jib's there, all Jib has to do is touch him. Breathe on him. Oh, this is gonna be OP. I'm thinking. To ice top at. It's actually kinda nice though. Maybe he should just be a little more immune than usual. Actually, yeah. That's what it should be. Okay, so he should be ice strong. Ice resist. That's the flag he needs. Alright. Metatron should basically have resist on all of his health. I think it's just resist. Which makes him ice resistant, fire resistant, poison resistant, lightning resistant, fear resistant, all that. But he still can be hit by it. So you can see, I should be able to freeze him, but he just, it just doesn't last as long. And I think that's the right way to do it. Draw boss has it. Yeah, flags resist. Ah, every boss should have this, basically. But definitely this boss. Okay. Too bad Jib's not there. Wouldn't even have to fight this guy. Okay, so now this is going to be a balance between the both what it was before, where he wasn't even being hit by ice, and now where he can be hit by ice, but it just doesn't last as long. Yeah, see, that barely lasted. That was like half as long. Dude, ice is going to be awesome, actually. Maybe too awesome. I just stopped him halfway in his tracks right there with that attack. Oh yeah, he's already in phase two. Okay, this is good because if you're a smart player and you're like, you have some ice, like, some ice for this battle is definitely gonna help you. Skill belt. Get him! Get him, Bell! You're not doing your job, Bell. You're supposed to make it so it's so easy to fight this guy. Remember all that damage you have? Yeah, the ice top hat is really great combination. It might actually be OP, I'm not sure. Ah, wasted a mega bomb. A kill a bomb, I mean. I always think it's funny when Belle dies. She dies really, really quickly fighting him. Maybe she should have more health. Maybe that's why she's not doing very much. She's always dying. Oh, that's right. So when you get hit by ice, you're immune to ice for a short period afterwards. What happened? I already lost all my... that time. Maybe it needs to be a little harder. She needs a gibbet. A little tiny gibbet. I think I can still run out the door. No, I can't. Oh, good. Alright. Easy. Jib with a bow. Okay, so it was easy for me to beat the final boss that time because I had all the items I needed. And yeah, for the final boss, it should expect you to have all the items you need. Like if you don't, that's what's great about it is it can make a huge challenge. I don't know. I kind of think he might actually be at the right difficulty right now. But if I were to make him harder, what would I do? 20 hours wasn't that easy. This is a development play though. You could have. You could do a little more damage physically. Maybe he does a whole one damage. And he's gonna have a whole phase three where he turns into something else. Yeah, that's where the really hard part will come. Because you'll probably use a flask. There are three flasks in the game, but I'm only counting on the player having one flask right there. So yeah, if you have three flasks, it'll pretty much make that boss fight easy, no matter what. Even if you have phase three of that boss and all that. But yeah, phase three, that's what'll make it really real. I'll make that guy for sure as tough as reasonable, you know? Dang, I wouldn't want to fight that. I really would not want to fight that guy in permadeath mode, though. Even as he is right now, it's hard. But I wonder if he could be more fun somehow. If there's something while I was playing that maybe I noticed it could be more fun. He's pretty cool. Maybe those pillars in the middle, those are actually pretty useful. If you're on the right side of the pillar when he's doing his tractor beam, I was using that a lot to like block my player from hitting him. Which means, yeah, if anything, I would increase the damage he does when you touch him, when you get stomped by him or whatever. I don't know, I think that's pretty good. Pretty good. I could ship this. Does he have a range attack? No. Not in that two phases. But that's a good thought, right? He does not have any range attack. I mean, the phase two when he's teleporting or like kind of like doing his own little blink or dash, that kind of is like a ranged attack because he quickly moves across the screen, which creates a damage box wherever he's at, you know. It's kind of like a long straight ranged attack almost, but it's not really because he's actually moving over that distance quickly. But yeah, maybe his second form or the phase three essentially could have some ranged attacks that would make it more interesting. And also I was planning on the second phase having the snakes, so he's gonna have some pet snakes, which I'm not gonna be able to finish for this version that I'm gonna upload tonight. But snakes for the next, for snakes and the third form. Summon lightning? Oh yeah, that's cool. Well, that's the thing. The snakes are gonna have all elemental effects. So there'll be like a fire snake, ice snake, lightning snake. Fear snake would be cool too. Poison snake. Thanks, Redeemer. Thank you. Okay, I think this is pretty good. I'm gonna pretty much leave him as he is for now. That was easy enough for me to beat him with normal items. So I think it's gonna be about the right difficulty for most people. You want a ghost snake? That'd be cool. Maybe one of them is a ghost snake. Maybe the fear snake is a ghost snake. Okay, alright, that's good. So I can start working on my list of bugs. How long do I have left? I got maybe like another half an hour I can stream. Then I've got to get lunch. The Jib Snake! All right, so I'm looking through my little list of bugs. So I just got, it's the truth about JB got eaten by a snake. He got eaten by a ghost snake. Yeah, Regathi and Jim eats a snake and becomes a dragon. Rawr. Okay, that's the most important bug. When I left the tower, it caused the first boss to reappear, which is really weird. Wait, what happens if I go back into the tower? Jib has a mouth? I don't think he does. Whoops. Whoops! On top of each other. That's kind of lame. Okay, so I killed them both, but I didn't ride up the elevator. So I ride this elevator because I want to go out and recharge my flask or something. Come back in here. Yeah. One dead, one alive. Okay, so it brought one of the bosses back to life, and one of them it kept as a dead boss. Wait, it only has... Oh. Yeah, so it has one drop boss dead, and then another drop boss dead, two of them. But they're separate entities because they have different positions and all that. So what happened, I think, is that when it there's this thing that resets the current Z level. It makes all the enemies come back to life. Where the hell is that? What function is that? World? That's it. Reset. It's just called reset. I wonder if it's so hard to find. What's up, Akuma? How's it going? Okay, so that just calls reset. I knew it was a simple thing. Area reset. Do we have that? Can we just do that here? Area. Bam! This is where you bring people back from the dead! What? Look specifically for dead. So we do not bring back dead boss, comma, but we did. What happened there? That was Droth boss, comma, dead. Oh, one of the bosses counted as dead, not dead boss. There's the bug. Found the bug. It's going as well as you could expect. Well. So why did it not save the boss as dead boss? I think it's here in save name. What's up, Anoanet? High five! Psh. What's up? How you doing? Here we go. Dead boss dead. Dang, why did it not find this? Okay, is boss. That means that one of these guys did not say is boss. Save name. This needs to be not just if we do the boss explosion, but if you are a boss. Okay. Constable is boss. All right, let's do this again. Hopefully that fixed the bug. That was a pretty important one to fix. And hopefully it fixes it for the other bosses too. Took you long enough to open up the door, game. Alright, so it should say here in the console when it's saved 119. Drop boss, dead boss. Drop boss, dead boss. Yes! I think the bug is fixed. So if I go out of the dungeon. Ah, very good. Okay, so it doesn't matter if I leave the dungeon. And if I beat this boss, I can go out of this dungeon. I can recharge my health. I can do whatever the hell I want. Come back here. Not have to fight this guy twice. This pair of guys. between Super Mario and World Dungeon and Phantom of the Opera. Yeah, cool. I was trying to go for an organ feel there. It still needs refinement, though. It needs to be better. Okay, this was a pretty interesting boss fight. I really enjoyed this one with these two guys. They turn into six guys. It's crazy. Crazy boss fight. Okay, so once again, I want to confirm that that works. So I'm going to go down a floor. It should reset the Z. I think. Let's make sure that does that. World reset? Where's it called from? Flux, that's right. Arrived overworld. Okay, so it's not going to be arrived overworld, but it is going to be, yeah. It arrived in arriving at any dungeon, any floor, any one of those. It's going to reset the Z. All right. So, I feel confident that by going down that elevator there, it called those that function. I'm going to go back up here and make sure that there's both those bosses are dead. Good. And I'm going to confirm it with data. All right, so 01185. Blob boss, dead boss, blob boss, dead boss. Cool. And let's see. It used to have blob boss times two. When I left, it had blob boss, dead boss, blob boss, dead boss. Good. Excellent. Okay, I'm pretty sure this bug is all fixed now. So you don't have to refight guys in the same if you've already beat them once. Final Dungeon's automatic permadeath. It kind of forces you to play more like that. Because you kind of, like at this point, as a player, I would have lost a lot of health fighting those guys and used a lot of bombs. Maybe even used up my flask. And I would be very tempted to go back to the overworld, use a refill pillar, or at least get back my... fight that other guy. Anyways, I wanted to teleport out after beating. Oh, that's where you get that demon tooth? I forgot. That's a huge power up. Okay, so if I teleport out and then teleport back. Good, I don't have to fight that guy again. Oh, and did it put its health on that other floor? That's crazy. Oh, so... how did it do that? How did it save those guys at a different place? That's weird. There's so many little bugs, so many visual bugs with this. I'm having to kind of overlook a lot of it. It's like, you know... the reflections look really weird when you go up the elevator and stuff like that. What's up, Beeps? Yo, high five, what's up? I want to check if I teleport out of this room and then teleport back. Oh, that's the. I don't want to teleport there. Cool. All right, this is great. Okay, so I've fixed a bug where when you're climbing the tower and beating bosses and stuff, it's not gonna make you fight the boss again if you've already beat him once in that run. Why does this door look backwards? Oh, because it's wait, the top of it. Oh, it is right. Okay, it looked weird to me for a second. Excellent. Okay, so let's assume I didn't do any of that before. I would have climbed the tower, beat four bosses. That last guy was pretty hard, remember that. Especially because I was low on items. But now that you can leave and come back, you can refill items and stuff. And then you get to here, you use this refill, and you can save on top of the tower before you fight. I was really unhappy with Slain. Yeah, I really didn't think it was a very good game. I played about half an hour and really did not feel compelled to keep playing Slain. However, I've found some kick-ass games this week. Downwell, so good. Downwell's epic. It's epic good. Such good gameplay, such good art, such good music. If you haven't played Downwell. Yeah, it did look so good. Totally. It totally looked awesome. Slain looked amazing. One of the big reasons why I bought it was because it looked so good. But playing it was just subpar. Subpar. Gameplay is just meh. This is a really fun as hell game. And it's like only $3. I really wonder what happens if I can make it all the way to the end. But don't tell me if you know. It's so polished. Like, playing this game is just awesome. Feels great. And it's got that Metroid vibe, which is why I love it. You know, I love Metroid so much. Okay, that's one bug off the list. Yes, let me check this in actually before I do anything else. Oh, let's tweak that. That was a good tweak. That was a really good suggestion. Thanks, you guys. Thanks, Jonah. You'll be transported to Exera? That'd be awesome. I'd be like, whoa. Did they predict the future? Oh, the Shadow Metatron fade should fade in a little slower. Let me write that on my list. Okay. Yeah, that is. It is. It totally is. Downwell has excellent polish. Slain really could have used a whole nother year of development. And it really needed some, like, creative freshness. Like, something to make it really fun. You know, it's like, the problem with Slain was that it was really predictable. all of the enemies worked in exactly the same way always. And it just made it just like not fun. You know, it was boring. I think if they worked on it a lot longer, they could totally make it better still. I know they've already relaunched it, you know, once, but it's got good enough art that like it just needed better gameplay, that's all. And polish. Oh no, you're easy to implement, nice to have features, a major game breaking. Damn. Yeah, what I should have done is I should have actually watched some gameplay videos before I purchased it, which is kind of my lesson lately. I've been buying games on Steam that I haven't watched any gameplay videos of, and so and then I get it and play it and I'm like, this is not that good. So I should just watch a little gameplay first. Okay, atomic commits, atomic commits. Oops. This one is can warp to refill on top of tower. Sometimes watching gameplay ruins it though. Yeah, that's probably why I didn't. Yeah, depends on the game. But yeah, hopefully watching like just 2 to 5 minutes or so of gameplay will not ruin anything, but yet give me the feeling of what this game is like to play, you know? I guess I would only do that for games I'm kind of question marking, you know? This is something I should do because I keep wasting money on video games. You know, it's like, oh shit, I just spent 15 more bucks on that and I'm never gonna play it again. Yeah, the tower progress is great. I just played through. So if you watch this video later on YouTube, you'll see I played through. I haven't got the four elements done yet for the snakes. There are going to be some snakes and more bosses and stuff. And the final boss will have a third form or a second form, but a third phase. So there'll be more stuff added later. I can't get it done yet today though. So I'm releasing another update to Steam tonight. So I've got one day left. You know, what can I accomplish today? I'm just going to get as many of these little bugs fixed as I can. But later when I come back and do another refinement pass on the tower, that's when I'll add those five different snakes. There'll be an ice snake, fire snake, lightning snake, poison snake, and a fear snake. And then there'll be one more version of the final boss, basically. So, and then I'll probably do some other interesting things like adding patterns and stuff like that to make the tower feel more unique. But yeah. Jimmers. If you play less than 2 hours and within 2 weeks, you can get a refund, no questions asked. Really? Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah, it kind of takes the risk out of buying Steam games. Oh, it's within 2 weeks, and if you've only played less than 2 hours, I could definitely get a refund then. Good. Oh, that's good to know. Because then I won't feel like I wasted, you know, money, and I could spend that money on a game I know I'm probably gonna like. Okay, so this is the boss. Oh, that's a pretty big important thing. Health system. Oh yeah, you did it for Super Meat Boy. Will Songbringer have chickens? Like Ocarina of Time style chickens? Where you pick them up and have to do some, like... Yeah, I wasn't very impressed with it either. Super Meat Boy, it wasn't really my kind of game. You know, I'm sure it had a freaking awesome big following, and I'm sure it was an amazing game for lots of people to play. But it's not really my cup of tea, I guess. You're bad at platformers? I really like platformers like Metroid, where it's like a long-term journey, you know, where when you have like a single level that's like a single screen, and then you beat that level and you can always go back to the, you know, in one of those games, like it's kind of like, it's almost like a mobile feel, mobile game feel. I don't really like those mobile game feels. Steam refund? Nice, Jimmers. Thank you. I'll do that. Yeah, totally. But on the bright side, out of playing a game I didn't like this week, it made me want to play a good game. So I tried Downwell, and I was so impressed with Downwell. Downwell is so good. Such a good game. You still have games on? You haven't even played? Like what? What did you buy and not play? Or get for free and not play? You love Downwell too? Yeah, like Spelunky. Spelunky is another one I should get. Oh, platformers are hard platformers. Oh, yeah, I totally know what you mean, Eves. Yeah. It's my fault that you didn't get anything done this week because you're watching Dark Matter. Dark Matter's pretty good, right? What's up, Sound Dongs? Yo! Spelunky, Risk of Rain. Risk of Rain is another one I didn't really like. But that's also got a huge following, and a lot of people love Risk of Rain, so I don't know. Maybe it's just not my kind of game. A recommendation. I would like to see a recommendation for a new Side Fury series, too, if anybody's got one. Blood Rain? Your worst game purchase ever was DayZ. Whoa, it was 30 euros too? Oh, see, maybe that's the problem. I played Risk of Rain and I didn't play multiplayer. Ah, that's the thing, huh? Yeah, it's a multiplayer game. Duh. I just tried to play the single player mode and I was kind of like, eh. Oh, cool. Spelunky Classic. I definitely want to buy the Spelunky that on Steam, though. Because I think I'm going to like that one. I finally started playing Binding of Isaac Rebirth. And I like it. I'm like, whoa, this is pretty good. It's cool. Once I figured out that you how to use items, I'm like, all right, now I get it. Now I see why Binding of Isaac's so fun. Because the items are crazy cool. Your worst purchase was Necropolis? I had that on my list for a while. I think I removed it from my list, though. Yeah, this was promoted on Steam recently. DayZ, whoa. See, it looks good, right? So why is Necropolis bad? Is it just like bad gameplay? That's what's so funny is like a game can look so good and then you play it and you're like, what's up with the gameplay? Because this looks epic. They messed up so much stuff. Yeah. I know what you mean. The same, I got the same feeling from playing Slain this week. They messed up so much stuff. So DayZ, I've heard of this one. Is that based on the movie? Wait, is it? No, it's not. Whoa, over 4,000 hours? Oh no, the developers switched. Oh, right, I've seen this one. Yeah. Wow, dude, this is a really popular game. Not recommended, not recommended, not recommended, not recommended. Whoa. How well did it do on Steam? Let's check it out. Need more content? DayZ, how well did it do? Shit, look at that. 3 million owners. 3 million owners at a price of what? Are probably around 30 bucks each. 3 million owners. That's $90 million. Gross revenue. Okay, what about Necropolis? $40,000 owners. Not a huge success, but that's quite a good success for a small indie studio if they're small. Oh, also it's a $30 game. Wow. Oh, you're talking about the mod, not the standalone, Teak. Oh, I get it. Steam takes, I think 30. Yeah, not 40, 30. It's kind of the industry standard these days is 30%. You know, Apple, Google, Steam. I'm sure the other ones. Well, okay, all right. So let me finish checking stuff in. What about best purchases? What are you guys' best purchases lately on Steam? What's a game that just surprised you? Like, oh my God, I bought this recently and oh, it's the dopest game ever. No, Apple's 30, yeah. Dang, left the project. Yeah, No Man's Sky, that's another big disappointment, huh? I never played it, but that's all I heard from the net was just disappointment, which kind of sucks. Okay, this is ready to check in now. Get at all. Wait, what do we got here? Get says, yeah, at all. This is Metatron, more awesomer. Lisa, the painful arch RPG. It's a $10 RPG Maker game. Lisa, is it this one? Just called Lisa. Oh, this was I saw this on somewhere. Oh yeah, this is the one that's like all kind of intense, right? With its content. The best world and story you've ever played. Wow. Oh, you have a Vive? VR games are pretty cool, huh? Let me add this to my wish list. This is, and look at this. This also has 3,000 overwhelmingly positive. How well did this game do? Audio Shield? This had, well, look at this. That's a good success. 200,000 owners almost. Audio Shield, is that a game on Steam? No? I guess it's a VR game, huh? Oh, wait, no, here, Audio Shield. It's a music game? Whoa! What? It's VR, huh? And it's a rhythm music game, yeah. Cool. The last game you bought was Party Hard. Wait, let me see Party Hard. Yeah, oh, this, whoa. Is it like a roguelike? Oh, is this the one where you kill everybody at the party? Oh, yeah. Was it good? Did you like it, Boogie? Nice. Elite Dangerous. Yeah, you were telling us about that the other day. Oh, yeah, you're talking about the fans of No Man's Sky. Yeah, it did. It made it like a hype feedback machine. Overwatch? Yeah. You have to hit the notes and you can put it in any song you want to. Oh, really? Whoa. Overwatch, you loving it? Yeah, cool. Oh, I got both those, Environment Station Alpha and Dungeon of Endless. Party Hard is such a stupid game, but mildly entertaining. Then I don't know if I'd like it if it's just mildly entertaining. But I know what you mean by those kind of games where it's like mildly entertaining. I don't know. I could put it on my list, I guess. Maybe I'll get it on sale. This sounds so first world to me. Yeah, hype. It is. It's a double-edged sword. Overwatch is on. Is it on Steam? No. This is what you just, it's just its own standalone, right? Or is it only on consoles right now? Oh, it's only on Windows? That's fine. I could play it. Is it free? No, it's not free. How much does Overwatch cost? $60. Cool. Oh, this is the Origins Edition. They have a Collector's Edition. Or there's a $40 regular one. This does look like a good game. Psych 2. The game is only bad if it's not enjoyable to play. Agreed. Thomas was alone. Sweet. I love this minimal graphics. Wow, this game did really well too, huh? You found your learning C++ book. Nice. Yeah, they got their own client, Battle.net and all that, yeah. Just like they always have. Whoa, look at this. Thomas was alone. 800,000 sales? That's incredible. This is like a $10 million game right here. Yeah, it's $40, yeah. Lethal League? Is it like a Street Fighter kind of game? Oh, it's an anti-gravity ball thing. Oh, okay. But it's fun. Cool. Yeah, I don't care if a game's new. I'm just looking for good games to play. Oh, Super Smash Bros. With baseballs. Cool. Awesome. Wow, thanks for the recommendations, guys. Clusterstruck? What's up, Buck? Oh, Cluster Truck. Cluster Truck. So have you played it? Whoa, this is crazy. Crazy good graphics. It's a chaotic physics-based truck former. Moirai? Oh, is this one from the guy that made like 100 games in a year? Yeah, I tried Titan Souls. That's another one of those games that I really just didn't like and didn't really want to keep playing after 45 minutes of playing it. Poke sheep. I'll save and link this one. Trust. Okay. All right. I trust you. Cluster Truck's Twitch integration? Really? That's cool. You can vote on ways to make it easier or harder for the streamer. That's sweet. Oh, Titan Souls? Too difficult? Yeah, it is. It is. It's really freaking difficult. It makes you start over all the time. There's nothing you can go and explore and do besides just go fight bosses. It's like, I was really hoping for more of a world from Titan Souls, because it gave you a world. It's like you had this world you could walk through, but nothing happens in the world. It's like, I wish there were secrets or power-ups or something to make it more fun to explore. That's what I felt like from Titan Souls. And it was way too difficult. Wait, pre-ordering Cluster Truck gets you the Tabs Alpha? Oh, totally accurate battle simulator? Cool, I'll play Moira. Totally accurate battle simulator. All these games I haven't even heard of, but they sound so good the second I hear it. Oh, because it's not even out yet. That's such a great name for a video game. Wow. I don't normally play 3D video games that much, but this one I might play. Yeah. It's even more silly than Go Simulator. Oh, you played it? Oh, is this like a web game too? Or something? Oh, the alpha. Watch it later. All right. Oh, watch that later. All right, I got you. Oh, really? Zero strategy? Tell this happened. Show me the chat log. There. I got it before it cleared the chat log that time. Awesome. Well, I've been streaming for like 2 hours now and I'm getting super tired and hungry. Not tired, sorry. Super hungry. It's like an hour past my lunch here. So I got a list of bugs I gotta finish tonight, and then I'm putting out this Steam update and all that. But I think that's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed that playthrough of Songbringer's final dungeon and final boss. But not the final boss, just the first final boss. All right, you guys. So have a great night. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time. Thanks again.